Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. My name is Kaizu and today we will be looking into all the fuel modifications for tier 10 medium tanks. So the first group of medium tanks we have are the assault medium tanks. Now we have the 430U in there and the E50M. So I brought up the E50M right here in the garage, and right here we have minus 50% to damage, MREC penalty and damage engine penalty, and minus 20% to dispersion of a damage cam. Now this is very, very handy in case you get MREC, because you'll be reloading much, much, much faster. Basically your MREC penalty will be halved, which is a really good thing. So I would definitely take this one over here, the first one, left one. Here you get the hull traverse speed and gun traverse speed at the cost of M. Nah, this is just bad. I don't take the right one here. Once again, we have aiming circle size reduction at the cost of dispersion during movement and dispersion during hull traverse. Now, when it comes to the E50M, I think this tank is very accurate, so you will not need the dispersion anyway, because the dispersion values are really, really good, and you want to pump up that accuracy to 0.28. On the third one, you would want to take probably the in the E50M's case. Now, the E50M has a very, it's not that bad reverse speed here, it's 20, but you will want to take the left one here because of the fact that it gets you a little bit of a faster getaway speed, which you will need when you're trying to engage enemy targets and you're trying to get away from them. Now, you will lose a little bit of camo value, but as you can see, this tank already has tremendously horrible camo, so it doesn't really matter that much. Also, with E50M, you're not going to be hiding that much. It's more like, as it says in the name, it's an assault medium tank, so it's a combination of a heavy and a medium. Now, on these ones here, the fourth field modifications, you have plus vehicle hit points at the cost of aiming speed, or plus aiming speed at the cost of hit points. Now, you will definitely want to opt for the extra hit points. This aiming speed reduction is very, very small, and you're not going to feel that at all. While you're getting some extra HP, which is always really nice. You can survive on 20 HP because of this and still be able to do damage. So I would definitely recommend taking the left option here. Now, on the eighth one, you have, this is interesting actually, you have plus 3% view range, minus 2% dispersion during ground traverse at the cost of engine power, ramming damage received, and ramming damage caused. Now, this is horrible, I think, because view range, you might get a little bit of extra view range, 12, but as I said, you're going to be fighting at close range most of the time, and you can probably get that view range with the use of vents on this tank to maximize DPM, which also gets you view range, and also you're going to have the commander and radio operator skills, which also get you view range. So this one is really good, I think, for the E50M, because engine power, as you can see, you get 40 plus horsepower, and that's really, really good for the E50M, I think. I would recommend taking this one. It also gives you extra ramming damage, because you're going to be ramming a lot of people with the E50M because of the speed. Once again, you have the option to choose a second special modification slot category, which in this case I think should be either HP if you want to have more HP. If you take the HP one, you're gonna have lots of hit points, which is really good once again, because you will have to trade and sacrifice your hit points in the E50M. But then again, it has really, really poor DPM, so you might want to use the vent slot instead. So you don't really need this one. Now, turbo on this tank, I don't really recommend it. You have really good specific power, you have really good top speed, so I think turbo is a waste. So I would probably play with vents, vert stabs, and rammer. Now, on to the 430U. So once again, we're gonna have probably the same field modifications here. Now, once again, the MREC penalty is huge for this tank, because this tank gets at the E50M as well, but this tank also gets MREC quite often, so you'll want to reduce that penalty as much as you can. So take the left option here. Once again, the aiming circle size is very, very good for this tank, because it doesn't have the most accurate gun. As you can see, it's 0.38, which is really, really shit. But if you take this one, you get a little bit of edge on the aiming circle size, which is always good at the cost of the dispersion, which is, well, it's not that relevant when you can reduce the aiming circle size. Now, you have the third option here. Once again, reverse speed on this tank is 18, which is really poor for a medium tank if you're trying to disengage from peaks that you made. So you might want to opt for this one. Now, you're going to lose a fair bit of camo, because this tank actually has really good camo. But You also get suspension repair speed, which is very common. You get tracked a lot because you're side gripping corners, so you want to go for this one here. Now on the fourth one, once again, I would probably take the aiming, sorry, the HP boost here at the cost of aiming speed. I think that's very, very good. That extra 40 HP, especially on this tank, I would recommend using HP on the HP boost, because you can get a hefty amount of more than 2.2k HP on this tank, which is really good for a medium tank. And you also have not bad DPM with this, with really good alpha and heat pen. So you want to take this left one here. Aiming speed is not good. This is gonna blow a little bit, but it doesn't matter that much. Now on the fifth one, you will want to take once again view range, but you want to take engine power. Engine power and HP are raw stats. This is what you need. Dispersion plus 3% is not gonna matter that much. The engine power is gonna matter a lot more in the long run. Once again, on the second slot category, you can select a HP booster, and as I mentioned, that you can get this up to 2.2k plus HP, which is really, really good for the 430U, because you'll be once again trading a lot with your opponents. Guys, we need to talk. I want you to press that subscribe button. Did you press it yet? I'm waiting, man. Thank you and enjoy the video. Now, the next group of medium tanks we have are the versatile medium tanks, namely the 140, the T62A, the M48 Patton, the Centurion Action X, the 121, the STB-1 and the UDES. Now, these tanks work fairly similar. There are some exceptions, but this should cover most of them. Anyway, here on the left side, once again, you'll want to take the MOREC penalty reduction, which is huge, because if you get MOREC'd, you're gonna have double your reload, and this basically halves it, so you're only gonna have like plus 50% of your reload, which is really good. Once again, you'll want to opt for the aiming circle size, no matter which tanks of these ones you're playing. Aiming circle size reduction is a raw stat, and you will need that, because you're gonna be sniping a lot with these kind of medium tanks, and also hitting those weak spots is fairly crucial. Now, here on the third one, this is an interesting choice. You get, again, top reverse speed, which is a really good stat. Suspension repair speed, which is always useful, but at the cost of camouflage. Now, I will leave this up to you guys, depending on which one of these tanks you're playing. Personally, I would probably opt for the reverse speed, because some of these tanks have only like 20 reverse speed, which is great, of course, but you can always make it better. I don't really snipe and I don't really hide a lot in my games, so I don't really use my camo that much. So I don't really care about the loss of concealment values over here, so I'll probably take the left one here. On the next one, you have heavy gauge nozzles and sensitive optics. Now, once again, you get top reverse speed at the cost of view range. Now, most of these medium tanks, I actually run HP on them. So, because you're running HP on them, that means that you can't mount optics on them, because you'll want to use word stabs and rammer as the second and third option. So, you will have no view range already. Now, if you choose this one, you can see that you lose minus 3% view range, which is really bad if you already have less than 450 view range on your tanks. So in these cases, I would actually not take any of these ones. I don't think any of them are really, really useful. You get plus 2 top speed, but maybe on tanks like the M48 Patton with good view range already, I believe it has 420 by default. You can maybe take this one, because it gets you a little bit of plus top speed, which may be useful. Now, as the last option here, we have reinforced support rollers and lightweight support rolls. Now, this one gives your tracks suspension durability. Now, there's a very interesting trick I discovered. Basically, if you assign in the second slot category the survivability slot, basically you mount an HP slot on it. Say you're playing an STB and you want to have more HP, you're going to have 2.2k HP. And that module already gives you track HP. And if you also mount this one, I actually discovered that if you get shot in the first track wheels, you will never get track for a shot, no matter what hits you. Jagdpanzer, FETD, nothing can track you for a shot, basically, on a medium tank. And that is really, really good, because a lot of times you're peeking, you get tracked, and then you get ammo racked instantly, right? In that case, you can peek, They will shoot you in the tracks, but you won't get tracked actually. So I would highly recommend taking this suspension durability if you are playing with HP on your medium tanks. But if you're not playing with HP on your medium tanks and you don't want to take any of these basically, because in that case you will lose suspension durability and you will get tracked by even the smallest shot to your tracks. So in that case, don't take any of them. Now the third group we have are the sniper medium tanks, which are fairly simple: the K91, the Leo-1, the AMX-30B, and the CS-63. Now there will be probably some exceptions because of the CS, and I'm not sure yet. We'll see. CS right here. Preview vehicle. Field modifications. All right. Once again, you have the classic for medium tanks right here. You're gonna probably go for the left one here. Not probably, always go for the left one here, just trust me. Once again, the MRI penalty as mentioned. Once again, aiming circle size is huge. Go for that one on every single tank whenever you get the option to do so. Turbocharger tuning. Now on the CS, I think it's really, really good because you really lack reverse speed on this tank. You only have about 15. By default. Now you want to pop that up with turbo as well, but if you take this one, it's gonna get you that little bit of edge once again, as explained on those tanks. Now if you're playing the Leo one, for example, you don't really want to go for this one. You might want to go for the concealment one, but it's not really necessary to even take any of these. On the CS, I would definitely take the left one. Now on these ones, loading mechanism tuning. This is actually a very, very interesting one. You get reload time at the cost of aiming circle size. Now, 9 out of 10 situations, this trade-off is good. Because you're not going to be sniping at 600 meters most of the time. You're going to be at close range, like 200 to 300 meters. Now, you will lose aiming circle size quite a lot, actually. But I believe in raw DPM. I believe raw DPM is the key to do consistent amount of high damages all the time. So I would definitely take the left one here, especially on tanks like the Leo one, which already have really, really good accuracy. You can sacrifice a little bit of dispersion, I think. Well, it's not a little bit of dispersion, but I would still take the left one here. It's basically like 1/3 of a rammer, which is really good. Now here you have engine power at the cost of aiming speed. Now on the CS, I would not take the engine power at the cost of aiming speed because the gun handling is already atrocious, in my opinion. On the other hand, on tanks like the K91, which already have really good aiming speed, you might want to consider taking this one. But once again, these ones are not that good. On the Leo one, you could definitely take the engine power or the aiming speed, because of the good accuracy of the gun, and that's also true for the 30B probably, but I would not really take any of these if I really had the chance. Now, as our final group of medium tanks, we've got the support medium tanks, which are the Batchat, the TVP, and the Progetto, so basically the autoloaders of the tech tree medium tanks. Progetto combines both aspects of TVP and the Batchat, in my opinion. Preview vehicle, field modifications, okay. So once again, you have the standard left, right, left options here. But in this case, because these tanks rely highly on camouflage and they all have fairly good reverse speeds, as you can see, 23, Batchat also has really similar, I think TVP also. So you will not want to take any of these, actually, because it just doesn't give you anything. And now if you take this one, you get plus concealment, but it costs you reverse speed, so no, don't take any of these guys. Here you're gonna have breech tweaking, which is interesting because it gives you minus 5% reload time. Now on tanks like the Progetto, actually, that might seem like a good choice, but you get a penalty to your aiming circle size after firing, which is horrible. It's plus 15%, so that's really bad, and you also get minus 5% aiming speed, which is already kind of atrocious, because you want to put your shells in quick succession. Now, if you choose this one, on the other hand, you will lose a shit ton of DPM, as you can see. It's already going down massively. So once again, on these kind of tanks, I wouldn't take any of this. Maybe, if you're running full shooting equipment, you can take this one on the Progetto. On the Badged, I would not recommend any of these, but yeah, I don't take any of these guys. On this one, you have top forward speed, top engine power at the cost of your range. Now, I think this is speaking for itself because you gain a lot. It's plus two top speed, and that's really good for these tanks because you want to get into those aggressive positions and you want to clip your enemies out as fast as possible from those aggressive positions. So you will definitely want to opt for the left option here. So once again, guys, thank you for watching the video. I am streaming every single day on twitch.tv/kaizu. So come and pay me a visit if you want to continue this kind of madness. Also, guys, subscribe and like if you enjoy the video, and I'll see you soon.